Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone. I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
All right, guys. No, let's not do that. Okay. Anyway, hi everyone. It's Ismay. Today we're going to be starting some Alan Wake. Hang on. Yeah, I kind of figured.
To the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
But there's something shiny over here, so we're going to go ahead and look at this first.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Heck yeah. Collectible thermoses. All right, Alan. We'll do what you want to do now. Wait. Is that me? Maybe. He has a thermos too. Oh.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder?
Just kidding, he has an axe.
You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them? You think it adds to the drama?
Yeah, I mean, that's how writing works. Go, Alan, go.
You missed your deadline! Damn.
Sorry. Oh, do I need him to break it? Okay.
You can't stop me!
Come here, buddy. Dodge too late. I mean, too early.
I realized that the hitchhiker
was highlighted with a cinematic. That's normal. Maybe you should stop writing.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Huh. I gotta say, it feels pretty great. This is all just his normal exercise routine. It's fine. Run, Alan, run. You're so slow.
This way, this way! Hurry!
No, clearly he's not in that, like, he's not that worried about it. It's fine. I don't remember, but thanks, man.
Oh no! Stop! No! Damn it, die! No! No! No!
There was no way out.
Oh, hi, Eyeboss. No way?
Die,
none
die,
at all.
Die.
Huh. Okay, can I read this book?
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
I'm trying, buddy. I don't know what you want me to grab.
Follow the light.
Okay.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Get into a safe haven. Got it. Huh, nice. Alright.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
There's a thing. Definitely.
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The Hitchhiker has been taken over by the Dark Presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Thank you.
Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away.
Yeah, you're good. Just burn you a little bit. Oh, no, it's just to be... Oh, not good. Okay. Oh, well... Okay, thank you.
You did it.
I just picked up my ammo.
The darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy.
Give me the gun.
Here, take the gun.
You can't give me ammo and no gun. Sorry, buddy. No remorse. Let me just pick up
good.
Some. Oh, wait.
You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
I don't want my nightmare.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
I know we probably still need to go there, but I'm gonna just... Thank you. Pick up a little bit of more ammo. I don't suppose another battery dropped? No? Alright.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill you.
Sorry, bud.
This is it, bitch!
Stop coming back to life. It doesn't have to be like that. Oh. You know, if you guys would just stay down, we wouldn't have to go through this. I need to get to that light. I need to heal back up. Ooh, what's this? Heck yeah. Okay. I'm not sure. Like, it said to hit one, but like, then what? Oh, okay. Got it. Three. Three is the flare gun.
Just like.
Or. Or not. All right. Okay. Ring out. Moving.
I can keep this up forever.
Same. Infinite ammo, am I right? By infinite, I mean 32 bullets, you know? I'm not sure if this came out before Life is Strange, but that's all I'm feeling right now. Oh, wait, thermos. Let's get them collectibles. No, Mr. Tornado. I needed my coffee. I'm sorry.
Just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Where is here, doll? Little town.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Are we?
Sure.
Are we not on vacation?
I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh?
That sounds interesting.
Did you hear that, honey?
I'm just over here while my wife takes pictures of us.
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Bain, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
Waiting for this plane to crash in the background.
A famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Maine, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
So we are on vacation. I thought we were just pretending to be on vacation.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry. We're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay.
Settling in. We're not even there yet.
That's the problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
This her car? Yeah, okay.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment.
I can't believe it. I've got all your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
Okay, thank you.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Can I sign it for her while we wait for this guy to get out of the bathroom?
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in
right.
love.
Right. So much for
your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black
do
coffee under...
Do me a favor, Sonny! I could really use a tune right now.
Sure, let me just grab this thermos first.
Number six in the jukebox.
What is this?
I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it.
Okay, well, first I'm going
to
turn on.
I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Wow, okay. Shouldn't you love your fans? But whatever. Let's play the song for this guy and then go into the dark.
Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
No, you're talking in my direction.
Yes.
Are you on your own?
Are you happy now, buddy?
With you?
This is
I can show you the town if you want. I get home for
No, I gotta
thanks,
go into
folks.
The dark.
We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
This is the creepiest little back area. Also, it's kind of rude of me to
Hello?
Just be like, I'm gonna go get this guy out of the bathroom.
Mr. Stuckey?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Okay.
Thanks.
Well, she's, let's go with Pleasant. Very pleasant.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
I'm sure.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Okay.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Are you good?
Splendid, splendid.
Do you need something else?
It swells up like a balloon.
The Andersons, they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Why are you telling me that? Okay. I don't see how that's
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Any of my business. Bye, Rose.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
I have a feeling we're definitely gonna need them, so thank you, Mary.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Oh.
That diner was a real nut house.
I hope we're still, like, going to the right
place. Can you
place.
Believe this place?
Oh, right, she gave us instructions.
This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home, okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
But what you're saying is I have major writer's block.
Good
job.
See those stars winking down at you? It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Diver's Isle.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's pretty, yeah.
Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I'm
okay.
Alice had a phobia.
A crater.
The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Bird leg cabin. A lot of crows. I was about to say, we were given a key, weren't we?
Take a look inside.
I don't know why you'd have to worry about getting inside.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Alright, look. I'm afraid... First of all, I'm probably gonna go down here. But, like, I'm afraid of the dark, too. But you have a flashlight. It's fine. How do I get into this cabin?
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
There you go, my queen. Now, ooh.
The lights are on! Good work,
basement.
Honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay!
This is a really cozy cabin.
A bit.
Sure thing! Have fun!
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work.
Maybe spend a little time with the wife. Here. Got dark quick, bud. Your wife is just pouring light out of the house. What is that on the porch? I want to go inside, of course, but I... Can I get around to the light? No? Alright. Back to the waifu it is, then. Honey, I'm home.
Alice? Honey?
Yeah, this.
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
One on the ferry, a famous artist, no less, but we'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on.
Stop talking about me on the radio. I told you not to. Alright, I was just looking to see if there was a thermos down here. You know what this needs? A hot tub. Alright. There's no fridge. Oh, there is a thermos though. Thank you.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
I thought you were gonna be in the basement because... Oh, hello, pants.
Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
Could you be the surprise, though?
Surprise!
Alice?
I'm not here to work.
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
hey,
keeps...
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No, it's
whoa,
not
Alan,
like that.
Relax.
That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it.
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
All right, thank I get that, like, maybe she should have waited at least a day before she was like, here, you should go back to work, even though you're avoiding work.
Alice?
But he didn't have to act like
Alice?
That, you know?
Gone dark.
Oh no.
All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you?
Just come outside, honey. It's definitely... Okay.
Alice! I'm coming! It's alright! I'm coming!
It's definitely brighter outside.
What the hell?
Alan, help me! I am. I'm dipping and dodging my way there.
Oh, no!
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Hmm. All right, not sure how we got from...
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma. By a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover.
I mean, your
either.
Fight, like, just happened. At least, probably, right?
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
All right, we can do it. I don't think we have our flashlight or gun anymore.
Damn.
I guess it's a good thing me and Alice were out of the car, huh? I don't think I have a stamina bar.
Hello?
Oh, it's the voice.
Hello? Is someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Lovely. As if we haven't already gone through that. Okay, someone hand me a flashlight. Flare gun? Something? Well, we can read those later.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Nobody you want. He's not reading into things enough yet. Oh, that's just gorgeous.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Yeah, maybe.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required.
Is this... Are you
Baird
doing this
squatter?
Because I grabbed the wrong key? Could we have been friends if I would have gotten your cabin key? Ooh, hey, hey, hey. Thank you. Ooh, manuscript. Oh, not great. Did I climb these? No? Just round? Alright. Oh, he's a freaking ninja. Something tells me I can't do that. No, I don't. Goodbye.
It's the lady.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Oh, perfect. Someone left the perfect ingredients out. Take all of these batteries, thank you.
During your
take this ammo.
Trying
that probably won't work, but
yes,
we're gonna try it.
Right fall sheriff station. Only I
Hello? Hello?
Roman! Let you
Oh, do I just let him come for me?
This is bad.
Oh, shoot. Okay. Where are we going? Do I get out? Do I stay in? Okay. That was a little weird. Let's leave, shall we? Thanks. You're dead. I mean, I guess
impounded with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone.
That's not true.
Something.
We did before.
There were no bodies. They just
Oof,
disappeared.
In a dream.
If I was
but
dreaming, it felt real enough
still
to make
did
me
it.
Sick.
Yeah, turn that electric fence off.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season.
Did he say running or renting? Come on, one more. Alright, now we'll reload. Take these batteries. I wonder if we'll get another flare gun. Anytime. Creepy lady.
What the hell was that?
That good sir was a horrible
when I saw the river
memory
below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
I already found a way across. Don't worry about it. It was laid out right in front of you. The water really cold or something? Is that why you're like, I get that it's going really fast, but it's not good enough reason not to even want to look at it, you know? Take that. Okay, can't go that way. Wait. I didn't find a way across. Okay. I was gonna say, I'm not sure if this is the right way or not, but if there's monsters, quote unquote, it has to be the right direction.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Yeah, he is. Ooh. Take this stuff. It's okay. I can see the gas station in the distance. Whoa. You're not throwing axes. I can't say it's entirely unfair considering I also have a ranged weapon, but rude.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
No, we just need magical light voice to come fix things again, right? Too much ammo. There's a thermos over here, I saw. Thank you. All right. We're good. Little cabin. Oh, everybody's here. These ones are more resilient. They take more light and more ammo. Hey. Hey. How about we don't? How about you don't? There's a flare gun when you need one. This could be.
With all this forestry equipment
so much
around,
easier.
There had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Maybe whatever this is? I don't know, but it did something. I'll just take this page of the book I'm apparently writing. I'll take this shotgun. Alright. Now, what did that start? Yes. Move log left. If I move it, might be right. Yeah, okay. My depth wasn't white working with me. Couldn't tell if my perception was a little off. Figure we'll just line it up and see what happens. Oh. Buddy. Somebody just have pallets everywhere. All right, we got up, so we need to keep going this way. Can heal up in this light.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and...
What is glowing on that? Okay, anyway.
The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear.
Yes, the night is gorgeous when you're not being hunted down by an axe-wielding maniac and his band of people that he's murdered.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Thank you, sir, miss.
Paul makes the best forms in the state. Belly Burster is the best with no crumbs.
Monster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
Are you sure about that? Oh, heck yeah, we got a cinematic. That's how you know we did good. Hang on. Oh, cornered myself. Oh. Crap. Okay. Get this turned back on. Then we'll reload, pick up that other ammo. Hello, we got a little stalking action going on. Oh, there's another one behind me. He's not as good with his... He's really... Okay. He's not so great at throwing. But it would seem he's alright at melee. Let's heal up. Might as well take the free heal while we can, you know? And we're moving out. Park from the left, too. I want a sickle. Come on, come on. Yes. Ow. I guess we should probably switch over. This page is glowing. That's abnormal. Who dipped my book in a glow stick? What have I got? Batteries and ammo? Perfect. I think we're going down. Are we gonna be chasing with equipment? I don't like that. Oops, we got three. All right, there's one, two, three. Perfect. They were little baby ones. Let's grab this manuscript, and then we'll probably have to go inside to open the gate anyway. I just want to grab that in case it triggers a cutscene or something. All right. Take this. I already have a shotgun, but sure, I'll take it. Anything fun on TV?
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein.
Yes, okay.
Sagan, princes among men.
Getting all fuzzy again. Where are the darkness people? Yeah, give me the lithium batteries. Oh. There you are. I'm a very angry patient man. Oh, just kidding. We have some lackeys to deal with. Oh. Right, we got one, two. Come on, last guy. Alright, there's those three. Alright, there's one down at least. Two down. I don't know if he's gonna spawn more. If he doesn't, we're good. I know we're in an intense little battle, but we need this coffee. Alright, come here, Sully. Stucky, whatever. I think you were Stucky, not Sully. Do you want to stop just running around in circles, sir? Hello? Come back here, friend. You're just letting this happen. I don't know if your AI broke or
leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come, assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Nah, don't worry about it. He wasn't that bad. Your wife yelling at you, like you yelling at your wife, was scarier than he was just now.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
They're gonna come to life and try to eat my face.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
No, hang on. Manuscript.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness.
Well, that's me.
Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Yes, a little bit, it seems. Oh, I can actually... Okay, games and activities, raffle, fishing, pie contest, surprise competitions, ooh, live music, Bucktooth Charlie, Montgomery and the Mystic Amazing... Don't miss the parade! Is there any coffee? There is coffee, but doesn't look like there's a thermos, so... Let's go over here. No thermos hiding with that stuff either. Wonder where the attendant went.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Yeah, hi, I still need help. I called earlier.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head.
Maybe the whole
Are you okay?
Maybe none of that happened.
Listen,
and we got
we'll figure this
crash.
Out. Please get in the car. We'll swing
the
by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
I mean, you could leave out the darkness details and be like, yeah, he attacked me with an axe and I shot him. I don't know if he lived or not. Let's go look for a body. This is obviously the end of episode one. I hope you guys enjoyed as much as I did. Had a nice little taste of the crazy that this game is going to be. I will see you all next episode to start.